I launched an AI Micro SaaS product that we built in less than a month and grew it to $1,000 a month in revenue. In this video, I will be showing you everything, how we did it, how it got started, what was our tech stack, our real Stripe numbers, server costs, development costs, and more. Along the way, I will also share with you the 5 key lessons about launching an AI SaaS that I personally had to learn the hard way. This video is probably just gonna be me doing a lot of screen shares and showing you everything, showing you all of our secrets so you can avoid those potential pitfalls where so many first-time founders fall when building a SaaS. So let's get started, let's dive right into it with the product demo. This is the current version of this product right now, and it's called OAI Widget, where OAI stands for, you guessed it, OpenAI. Essentially, this is just a custom AI website widget built on top of the latest OpenAI Assistance API, and it can answer your customers' questions based on the knowledge that you upload. So if I ask our homepage widget, for example, what makes this product different, as you can see, it provides me as a potential customer with a pretty good response. But that's not it. You can actually connect these widgets to any APIs. So this widget is actually connected to our customer support API, which means that it can actually submit customer support tickets for me. So now let me say that, for example, my widget is not opening on my website. It then asks me to provide a bit more details. And once I do that, the customer request has been submitted. Yes, so now if I open our customer support inbox, you can indeed see this new customer support ticket from myself. Awesome, right? So this is how it works. But now let me show you the user interface itself. So to create an assistant, we first need to go to the Assistance tab, then click Create, select your API key, and then click Create again. Now you can customize them just like on custom GPTs. You can enter name, description, instructions, and also upload your knowledge and add any APIs. Then, unlike custom GPTs, you can actually take out this assistant and integrate it into other channels like a widget. So let me create a new widget, add this assistant, and then you can also even customize it to match your website by changing colors, icons, start message, and so on. So I thought this was a pretty cool and simple SaaS idea that we could build really fast, and some people find it really useful. However, what we surprisingly figured out later on from customer support requests is that users were trying to use these widgets as standalone applications or as sections on their website. So some users literally just embedded them on empty white pages in order to use them separately and share them with others. So this was the first most important lesson I had to learn the hard way. Always listen to feedback. Feedback was hands down the most valuable thing from the entire launch because it allowed me to really understand where we could take this product next. I honestly never thought that it would become something more than just a widget, but because of customer feedback, I realized that there's a lot more potential to this. So this is why we decided to release this new feature next called Custom GPTs. Essentially, it's standalone chat applications with more highly requested features like white labeling, managing user access, adding multiple assistants, accessing chat history, using voice, uploading files directly in the messages, and more. And you can actually see a noticeable bump on our Stripe dashboard after we release this feature, which I'm gonna show you next. But before I do that, just so you know, this product now looks completely different. I now have a much bigger vision for this product, which is another bonus tip that I'm gonna talk about at the end. Okay, here's our Stripe dashboard. So as you can see, we peaked at around $1,000 a month, and then it slightly went down a bit. This is the bump I talked about earlier when we released custom GPTs and sent out a small email campaign. Literally, the whole marketing for this product was just me releasing one video about 8 months ago and nothing else. I just literally released one video, and then I was also sometimes attaching a link to this product under some of my other videos, but I never promoted it again. At first, to be honest, I was really disappointed by these numbers because right now, you know, my B2B agency makes 50 to 100 times more depending on the month. But what I realized later on is that it's actually not that bad. Because if you look at our Vercel, which is our front-end hosting that we're gonna go over later, we haven't released anything for more than 4 months, okay? That's insane. Because imagine if we did this in our agency, right? Imagine if we completely forgot about our service for more than 3 months. We would probably have had like a dozen of lawsuits right now, and it would immediately go down to zero. But this product just keeps working by itself with barely any involvement from my end, which is just insane. So this is the second key lesson that I learned, is that it takes you much longer to grow a SaaS product, but it's much easier to sustain it. This is why SaaS products can be sold for such tremendous amounts of money. You don't have to constantly hire and train new people, so you can scale it as much as you want. Now let's take a look at how we actually built this and what was our tech stack. So for the front end, we are using Next.js, which is one of the most highly respected and modern web frameworks out there for building reactive web applications. Additionally, we are using Material UI, which is a component library. I definitely recommend you guys check out some component libraries if you're tight on a budget, because they allow you to build front ends much faster. Essentially, they provide you with a set of pre-made components like buttons, different tabs, tables, and so on, so you don't have to create everything from scratch by yourself. Other options include Bootstrap and Tailwind. For our backend, we're using Firebase, which provides you everything you need to develop scalable apps like this, including authentication, database, and backend APIs in a single SDK. We are running our backend primarily on Firebase serverless functions. However, there are some other services involved. In my opinion, serverless is perfect for AI apps, because with AI, you typically have some services that are used a lot more frequently than others. Like, for example, in our app, we have a get completion function that runs your assistant and returns a new message, which probably gets like 95% of the traffic compared to all other endpoints. And with serverless functions, you can scale each service independently, so you don't even have to think about any server management. The disadvantage of serverless is that most likely you're going to be locked in with your provider for life. However, the real reason we're using this stack is because of the developer experience. This is the third key lesson that I learned, is that the developer experience is key for success in product business. You see, developer experience is often overlooked, but it's actually your highest paying cost when you're building a product, at least at the start. This is the most likely reason of why your product can fail. You simply run out of money to pay for the developers before you find your product market fit. So we'll go over all the costs later, but I'll tell you right now that any other costs like server costs are absolutely negligible compared to the developer costs that you're gonna incur at the start. So this is why I like Firebase so much. It only takes you like 7 lines of code and 5 minutes to set up authentication. You can access your database directly from frontend, which saves your developers a ton of time. And all you have to do to deploy an entire app is just run a single command. Then you never have to think about it again, because Firebase will scale and manage everything for you. Not many people know that Fireship's channel is actually named like this because he started from Firebase tutorials, all of his first videos about Firebase. So if you want to avoid building a clunky 3-page SaaS product for $200,000, I definitely recommend checking out some more modern tech stacks. If you prefer an open source alternative, there is also Supabase and Pocketbase. However, even with the most modern frameworks, with all those SDKs, most SaaS products still fail, because there is one more crucial component that all first-time founders tend to forget, and that is the people component. So the fourth lesson that I learned the hard way is that every SaaS business is also a business. Even if you're building a micro SaaS, there is always this business component involved, and there are so many other parts like marketing, sales, customer support, and so on that you need to consider. So if you really want to grow a product, you can do it by yourself to a certain extent, but at some point, I'll guarantee that you'll just get stuck. Instead of working on long-term vision and strategy, you'll be stuck doing lower value tasks like customer support, finances, and bug fixes. So at some point, you'll definitely need to consider hiring people. And to do this effectively, you need to have some systems in place. So personally, we are extremely organized around Notion. Notion is our single source of truth. So whenever people need anything, whenever they're working on this project, they simply open this project card in Notion and they have everything in front of them, including tasks, files, notes, and so on. This helps them to actually focus on doing the work rather than just chatting around when looking for API keys or any other information. Additionally, we have extensive playbooks, which are like training materials for our employees that help them to onboard on projects faster. All of these were personally recorded by myself while I was doing all the development alone. We also have CI/CD workflows that automatically run tests and deploy the application, so we can also save some time on that. A great practice that you can implement right now if you're building a product is test first. So don't stress about this in the beginning. You can easily get started by yourself. And once you begin to grow, simply record how you do things and then hire someone else to do them for you. That's the whole idea. All of these processes and playbooks are literally just hours of recordings of myself on how I used to do things when I was all by myself just getting started. Now, let's take a look at the costs. Okay, first here are the OpenAI costs. On our platform, as you saw before, users actually provide their own API keys, which is why the only OpenAI costs we incur are for this homepage widget. So the total OpenAI costs are pretty low, only at around $20 a month. However, I believe on the first month of the release, in December and January, we actually got much larger bills. Yes, as you can see, we actually got $140 and $100 respectively. It is still using a previous GPT-4o Turbo model. So now, actually, with the latest GPT-4o model, I believe it should be 4 times cheaper as well. Now let's check out the Firebase costs. So as you can see, it's around $90 a month. However, most of these are actually non-Firebase services. This is because for some critical cloud functions like get completion, we are setting min instances to 1. This allows us to slightly decrease the latency, but it's not necessary. So this means that if we keep scaling it, only those $30 on top will increase and the $60 on the bottom will stay the same. Vercel, which is our front-end hosting, also costs us $20 per month per developer, so this adds another $60 on top. However, you don't really have to add all your developers there. You can, for example, just add your front-end developer or just yourself. And we're also using Vercel for many other applications that we develop for our clients. But even like this, if we completely stop working on this product right now, it means that our monthly profit would be somewhere around $600 a month. However, as I said in the beginning, this is not the cost that you should be worried about. If you're just getting started and if you don't have funding, development costs is where you need to really pay attention. So we also keep track of all our budgets in Notion, so I can tell you exactly how much we spend for this release of the product. So the last release was on April 22. We did develop it more. I'll talk about this at the end. But up to this date, as you can see, it took us $8,000 to develop this complete product to that point. And the net volume on Stripe right now is $6,000. So with all the costs and everything combined, we are now at a loss at around $3,000. So I'm sure I could have taken this product much farther if I just posted more videos. But the primary reason we are still so low in revenue is because 95% of our active users are using this product completely for free. And I know there is a lot of hype right now in software about freemium models. However, if you don't have funding, if you're bootstrapping a SaaS yourself, you really can't afford to spend a year building a product without revenue. So the final lesson that I learned is that you should not consider freemium models if you're bootstrapping your SaaS. This is what we are going to do in our next update, which should be ready by the time you watch this video. Okay, before I talk about this update, actually the bonus tip that I wanted to tell you is that you always need to have a very large vision when you're building a product. Otherwise, there's absolutely no reason to start in a SaaS. Don't be swayed by those micro SaaS trends like I was. They may be micro, but they still require big effort. There are so many other business models that can make you a lot more money with a lot less effort much faster. The only reason for building a SaaS is if you're planning to go big. So your vision needs to be aligned with that. This is what I'm gonna do now. No more micro SaaS. Now this product is gonna be called Agency AI and we're planning to go big. It is now fully based on my open source agent framework and it is designed for developers to help businesses unlock a new level of AI automation with AI agents. We added a ton of new features and improvements, like for example, advanced tabs for custom GPTs and widgets, streaming support, advanced parameters for agents, more models, API integrations, Slack integrations, and a Skool community. So I'll probably be doing a completely separate video on that later, but the price for this product is now $79 per month, no freemium, and now we'll be doing releases weekly. So I hope that by removing freemium model, we can actually get some cash flows to build out this product even more and really go big over time. However, right now we're only opening 200 spots at the moment because I want to provide the best possible support for everyone in our community. So thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe.